What's up, scholars? Noor here, and welcome to Book of Showtime Chapter 63. As always, if you enjoy these videos, be sure to leave a like and share with your friends. And if you have a topic you'd like for me to cover for Book of Showtime, be sure to leave it in the comment section down below or anywhere you can reach me on social media or the Book of Showtime Discord. So Ben says, my suggestion is gaming crossovers you would like to see. No collaborations, this has to be an actual mashup. Fortnite skins and Dead by Daylight and other stuff like that are not included. So as you can see, Ben requested this a long time ago, and while I had some ideas, nothing really came together. I was trying for months, but I finally got an idea. Back during the summer of 2020, I did a Twitch event called Summer Gauntlet, and each week I would do a top 7 list based on a topic given to me by the community, which basically this is kind of like the nucleus or the idea that started Book of Showtime. One of the top 7 lists were top 7 crossovers I wanted to see. Now, I've actually taken some creative liberties with this suggestion and this topic and decided to do more of a remix or a clash of gameplay than a crossover, and today I'm bringing it back with some of the original games, this time with a few new concepts. First up, let's remix Yakuza or Like a Dragon and Tekken. Let's get an easy one out of the way. The main reason we haven't seen series protagonist Kiryu Kazuma appear in a fighting game is because the series creator isn't fond of the idea of Kiryu hitting women, which I can understand, even though we all saw Kiryu slap fire out of Haruka in the first game. We all saw that, right? The easiest way to circumvent this, and by easy I mean expensive and time consuming, is to make a Tekken game but with exclusively Like a Dragon characters. There's no shortage of colorful and personable characters from just the first few entries alone, so drafting a deep roster wouldn't be an issue. The Like a Dragon games already boast fun combat and tremendous music to go along with plenty of iconic set pieces, something which Tekken is no stranger to with its signature 3D plane fighting and stunning stages. The arcade boss in such a game would have to be at the top of the Millennium Tower, come on. Tekken 8 actually just introduced a new heat system, so if you're a fan of Tekken or Like a Dragon, you would feel right at home. Maybe we would even see a handful of characters from Tekken make the jump, it's only right. Also guys, let me know down below, do you want to see a chapter where I build out a Yakuza fighting game roster? That would be amazing. We'd have to establish some rules for it, but if you guys want it, I'll do it. Moving on, let's remix Time Crisis with Gears of War. Two classic games with similar rules, take cover or die. Can you imagine how awesome this would be? Imagine going into a Dave & Buster's or any other arcade, I mean what arcades are there left that aren't Dave & Buster's, and seeing two Lancer gun cons ready to go, or maybe even the Mark III Lancer since it has the grenade launcher, and using grenades would fit the faster gameplay, and light gun fans would be familiar with that mechanic since House of the Dead 4 had the Uzi with the grenade button on it. Sorry, I'm getting excited. By the way, did you guys see that Gears of War E-Day trailer? That premise is amazing to me. We've had minor glimpses of E-Day periods in a Gears game before, but a full game based around E-Day? I am super sold, I need that. A long time ago, there were actually rumors of a Gears of War rail shooter coming to the Xbox Kinect way back when it launched. You guys remember the Xbox Kinect, but no such thing has happened. In fact, the Gears of War spinoffs leave a lot to be desired, but I digress. I think hanging out with a friend while blasting locusts across various iconic Gears set pieces would make for an awesome experience. I'd even buy one for home play if they had it. Xbox would make billions and then they would shut down the studio that made it. Time Crisis has been dormant for a long time, but everyone remembers that signature pedal cover mechanic that separated it from other light gun games at the time. A system like that just seems tailor-made for one of the seminal third-person cover shooters of our time. Fun little quirky story, I actually yell out machine gun or grenade gun when picking up said weapons in games just because of all the time I spent playing Time Crisis 3 as a kid. I miss arcades. Also, if you're a cute femme, let me take you to Dave & Buster's, girl. Hit me up. Next, let's remix Rainbow Six Siege with Phasmophobia. Every game would be better with guns. Life is Strange would be one episode long if Max just had that tool on her. Trust me, she was too skinny to not be strapped anyway. Now listen, I'm not body shaming, alright? I ain't exactly Marlon Brando in his prime myself, but if you weigh 80 pounds soaking wet and in boots, you probably aren't winning any scraps, so stay strapped, scholars. But I digress. The idea for a Phasmophobia Rainbow Six mashup actually came while I was playing House of Ashes, as the tight military supernatural setting just seemed perfect for me. Most Phasmophobia locales can just as easily be Rainbow Six maps and vice versa. Imagine a haunted Hefford base or haunted theme park, that would be awesome. Every Rainbow Six operator also has unique gadgets, so what if you add that level of coordination to Phasmophobia? It would make the game a little hard to play solo, but most of the time people are playing with friends anyway, and it would add a layer of difficulty if, say, the person who had the spirit box died and things of that nature. I think it would spice up a game that can often be very boring at times. I'll be honest with you guys, as fun as Phasmophobia can be when you have a full team, there are a lot of periods where nothing happens. I'm talking upwards of 15 minutes of just staring at monitors waiting for something to happen. A light combat mechanic would also make the game easier if you had more options to ward off ghosts. Maybe during hunts it would be like a small boss fight with most tactics shifting over time as the ghost grows more powerful and sanity drops. Maybe multiple ghosts can be present and you'll still try to hide like before, as shooting can give away your location and force you to fight longer and burn resources. Can we get some type of milsim paranormal game? I'm actually salivating at this concept. Out of all the competitive multiplayer games that I've played, Rainbow Six is one that actually has some natural tension. There's a point where one team is waiting for the other to blink, to get restless, to make a mistake. Phasmophobia also has long periods where you sit around waiting, whether it be to catch a dodge projection or wait for a manifestation to get that elusive picture. Combine that with proximity radio chat, this could be a very haunting and immersive experience. Next up, Dead Rising remixed with Silent Hill. These are two series that actually feel tailor-made to be remixed with each other. Silent Hill feels like a game, well, at least to me, the first two, feel like games right on the edge of being open world when it comes to navigating the town, but the game still feels contained as to not have you wandering around aimlessly. Dead Rising is an open world game, much lighter on the tone, and while the plot tends to be grounded and dire, the gameplay and side cases are pretty silly at times, which is Capcom's MO, you know, grounded but sort of goofy and not taking itself too seriously. Silent Hill sees you use a variety of melee weapons like pipes and swords as opposed to focusing on firearms, a trait shared with Dead Rising. Imagine fighting one of those creepy inside out, upside down creatures and your weapon breaks. Heck, imagine it breaking during a major boss fight. And can you imagine Silent Hill with a time mechanic and an enemy's killed mechanic affecting outcomes? It'd be stressful. I feel like the gameplay of Dead Rising would fit naturally for Silent Hill, as being in a hostile environment, you're going to be grabbing whatever weapons you can to fight back. The one non-detraction about Dead Rising is that while it is technically a horror game, it is not scary on any level. Is there tension? Yes, as the limited time you have to complete objectives forces players to be selective and think on their feet, yet Dead Rising still seems to be almost zen-like for a zombie game, so dipping it into a vat of fog and psychological guilt trips would be a wonderful blend of two tense genres. Before we get to the last concept, here's what Vinny had to say about two games she wants to see remixed. The puzzle series Puyo Puyo and the bullet hell series Tohau. Both series have magical girls and a cute aesthetic, yet are deceptively hard. The characters would lend to each other's art style really well, and with both games having whimsical yet badass music, there's tons of potential for crossover sonically too. Plus, both series have already proven they can be mixed into other game styles well, with Puyo's mashup with Tetris and the multitude of Tohau spin-off games in parody of other game styles. Both involve numerous objects descending the screen, and I think there's something there. While I've never played or heard of Tohau Project, I have played a couple of Puyo Puyo games with Vinny, including the aforementioned Puyo Puyo Tetris, which, man, I hate those games. I feel like no matter how good I do, I still lose. No matter what I do, I still lose. So down with the Puyo and up with Tetris. But yes, from a quick bit of research, these games do seem to have styles that would gel very well together. Finally, my last concept today, Sonic Adventure 2 mixed with Stardew Valley mixed with Cult of the Lamb. You might be confused with these three, it sounds really random, but hear me out. Plus, I can already hear the furry allegations from wanting to put Sonic and Cult of the Lamb together. I will be fighting those allegations. The one thing that I've always wanted for years from the Sonic franchise is a game focused exclusively on raising Chao. I really loved the Chao raising in Sonic Adventure 2, and I really loved taking care of my flock in Cult of the Lamb. So much, in fact, that I turned on unlimited health so that I can blaze through the combat sections faster to get back to my flock. Now, as to why we would be mixing those two, well, the flock in Cult of the Lamb has personality, levels, loyalty, and there's a lot more you can do with them as you manage your little village. I'd like to have something similar when it comes to raising Chao. As to where Stardew Valley fits into this trifecta, its rich farming gameplay that would mix with the base management of Cult of the Lamb would be very fulfilling. Stardew Valley also has a town with plenty of NPCs which could be new and existing Sonic characters. Stardew Valley also has a bit of dating sim vibes to it as well, again ignoring the furry allegations, but wouldn't it just be nice to get married and raise space babies together? You know, that's the common male fantasy. Now, where all three of these games can really come together would be the action side of the game. The runs that you go on would compose of the treasure hunting and the mech missions from Sonic Adventure 2, with random elements and rewards from Call to the Lamb and Stardew Valley, respectively. There's a lot of fun gameplay elements from these three games, and blending them all together would be the ultimate farming management sim. Alright scholars, thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know down below, out of all these concepts, which one would you be most excited to play? Let me know down below what two games you want to see remixed. Inshallah, I will see you in the next chapter.